Yeah.
And now, our feature presentation.
Just like you, just like me, when you go home to your family and tell them, I heard something from the messenger of Allah. What messenger? What Allah? See? You say, this is a man from God. Oh, come on. This is what they'll tell you. And when you try to convince them that what you heard is from the messenger of God, they laugh at you. They mock you. They scorn you. And if you're weak, you'll say, well, maybe I was mistaken. But if you're strong, the more you stand up, the more they'll say as they watch you, there must be something to that man Muhammad. Because I see the change in you. Remember that. Has the messenger had any further contact with Master Farah Muhammad since 1943? You mean 1934? Yes. All the time. All the time. Well, explain yourself, brother. You mean he calls him on the telephone? Well, I don't have to talk to you on no telephone. Telephone was an idea of an imperfect man because of the imperfection of his ability to manifest supreme mental power. Therefore, he electronically puts your ear to the ear of somebody that you were speaking to on the other side of the country or on the other side of the world. But it's not necessary that you use telephones if you get your house in order. The messenger said there was a time when we were righteous and clean, which is righteous, and in command of ourselves, that we listened to each other think. And we will be able to do those things again, and there are some among us who can do those things now. And this is nothing spooky. You just have not met such kind of person. This is why when you meet Muslims, a Muslim, when you really meet one, they'll frighten you. Yes, they will. They'll frighten you. Because when you think that you're not seen, they see you. And when you think that they didn't hear what you said, they not only heard what you said, they heard more than what you intended to say. Because they're getting a wake upstairs. And the more you get a wake upstairs and the cleaner you get upstairs, you don't need but a word here and a word there, and you got the whole picture. Then pretty soon you don't even need words. There are times, and I'm not being spooky, I don't hear you think. I don't hear you think now. I would be a liar if I told you that. But there are times when I'm very, very perceptive and I can just look at you. And what you radiate will tell me pretty close to what you're thinking. Now, if I keep going, I won't even have to look at you. I can be off somewhere and listen to you and even picture you. That's how Allah sees. The physical eye is limited. But with the spiritual eye, the messenger says you can put the whole world right in the palm of your hand and look at it. In the spiritual sense, with the physical eye, you can only see what the physical eye and light will permit you to see. But with the physical eye, spiritual eye, you see with the light of knowledge. The greater your knowledge, the more perception you have, both in hearing and seeing. Could you please explain to me why we are Asiatic blacks and not Africans? Yes. Messenger Muhammad says that at one time the whole planet Earth was called Asia. If you go look up old maps, before the white man called that part Europe and that part Africa and another part Australia and this part America, North America and South America and the West Indies and this, that and the other, whole earth was known as Asia. The part up in Europe, which is very hilly and full of caves, was called Eurasia. This part over here, the untrodden wilderness, was called West Asia. The part that is called Africa was called, as Messenger Muhammad teaches us, the jungle of East Asia. And the only inhabitants of the earth was the original black man. So if the black man was the only inhabitant of the earth, there was no brown, there was no yellow, and there was no white, since these races came about 6,000 years ago, then all before that, the original black man was referred to by the name Asiatic, because his whole home was the earth. Not a part of the earth, the whole earth is the true house of the original black man. So we don't say African black man in reality, because the word Africa was given, as Messenger Muhammad teaches us, to that continent by Alexander the Great. He named it Africa. Americus Vespucius was the person that they named America after. Is that true? But they don't tell you what its name was before these white people named it. All of it was Asia. And we who lived on the planet long before there was a white man, a brown man and a yellow man, were referred to as Asiatic black people. When you taught on Master Farah Muhammad, you said that God heard our moans and groans, and he would go down and see why this is so. Where would he be coming down from? It's written in the scripture, whoever wrote this, that God would come down. He heard their moaning and their groaning, and he would go down to see whether their cry was altogether what he had heard. That's the language of the scripture. Going down doesn't mean he dropped out of the sky onto the earth. There are many ways to express down, for down is only a relative term, isn't it? Come on. When you come from an elevated state and an elevated civilization of righteousness, if you step into a civilization of wickedness, evil, indecency, and confusion, you have stepped down. Therefore, the scripture says, he went down into hell among the dead. It doesn't mean that he actually went under the ground from up in the sky, but he came from the holy land, the heavenly part of our planet, the holy land, and he came to North America by himself, and he went down into hell, because America is hell to every black man, woman, and child, and the black man of America is mentally dead. And coming from a righteous state into this filth is definitely going down. Please explain the significance of the birth of the twins, Esau and Jacob. Boy, you are really getting into some things tonight, huh? Someone bring me some water, please. Rebecca, in the book of Genesis, I believe, was pregnant. And the scripture says that two manner of people would be separated from her bowels. And the younger would rule the elder, and the stronger would serve the weaker, something like that. And these two were fighting in the womb before they were born, if you remember the scripture. And when one was to come out first, it was pulled back. And there was born Esau and Jacob. The messenger said that all of this is symbolism. In the sperm of the black man, which represents Rebecca here, there is a brown germ and a black germ. These germs always are structured with the positive black ruling over the negative brown.